From the Webflow dashboard, your workspace, you can access, create, and manage your sites. Let's get right into it. And we'll cover this in just two steps. We'll look at the dashboard itself and how it aligns with your workspaces and their settings. And we'll look at the options we have to access and organize our sites in our workspace. Let's start with the dashboard itself. Okay, once you've logged in and set up your account, you have your dashboard and your workspace. If you're starting from scratch, you'll have no sites in your workspace. But if you're joining another workspace, there could be multiple sites available to you. So for us, we have access to a few workspaces. You might have just one, and that's okay. With this one selected, let's take a moment to look at our options here, almost at the top. We have the name of the workspace we're in and the workspace plan next to it. This is the plan for the workspace, not the site plan. We can search for sites in our workspace. That's helpful if you have a lot of sites, not so much if you only have one. We have some sorting and viewing options. So based on your preference, you can choose whatever you like. We're keeping it as is. And here at the end, we can create a new folder where you can add sites to organize them. And finally, we can create a new site. This is where you can either start with a blank site, find the template that you like from the Webflow Marketplace, or even try out the AI site builder. Okay, let's look at some of the settings here on my left, which is your right. And if you're watching this facing upside down, it would be your right and my left. So one note here, depending on your role in the workspace, your visibility here might vary. But this is an admin view. In your general settings, you can make general workspace changes and change site access settings. You can choose who can see which site or sites in your workspace. Okay, those are the basics of the dashboard and our workspace or workspaces. Let's talk about access and settings for each site, all those thumbnails we see in our workspace. So we're back in our All Sites tab, and these are all of our sites, all the sites that are in this workspace. And if we hover over these thumbnails, we get a couple of options. We can open up the site itself and go in and start working on the actual site, the actual design, or edit the content. Or we can access the site settings. And keep in mind, these settings are just for this site. And as we can see, there are a lot of things we can do here. In this general tab, there's the option to rename your site, add it to a folder, add your fave icon and web clip.
Wait, do you mean favicon?
Yeah, or it's fave icon, right?
No, it's favicon, not fave icon.
Ah, like favicon.
Yes, that's it.
Thank you. Okay. Instead of us going in and clicking into every single tab here and explaining things with long and lengthy sentences and honestly most likely lose your attention, let's bring up a graph. Here we have the icons, the titles, and a short explanation of what each tab is all about. And while you're skimming through this really quickly, I'm going to take a sip of my coffee. Okay, let's move on. If we go back and if we look at all our sites, we can see that for each site, we have a name, an actual link to that site, an icon indicating if and when that site was published, and what type of site plan it's on. Each site has to have its own site plan. And if we hover over and click in on these three tiny dots, we have more options. And to be honest with you, these are sort of shortcuts to a lot of the same options we have in the general tab settings for each site. So, another way to access these things quickly. But one thing to note though, if you're archiving a site, make sure to unpublish that site first and remove access from any collaborators on that site. That's helpful if you want to free up space in your workspace and manage any plan limits you run into. Before we wrap up, let's look at the top bar real quick. Okay, let's recap. We have our dashboard, which is your home base and where we have access to our workspace or workspaces. And within each workspace, you'll have access to sites and all their settings. And finally, I learned an important lesson, how to pronounce fave icon. That's a basic overview of the dashboard and workspaces in Webflow.